Really hard, but was always seemed to get on top. But I can't see this one being easy at all.
You're sure to be singled out for extra attention. Does that worry you?
No, not really. I'm just going to have to keep getting up, that's all.
Has the loss of last year's grand final still in your mind?
Yeah, that's what I think made the team all that more determined not to lose this one. You know, it's no use coming 2 years of football and losing 2 years grand finals, just like Parramatta and Sydney. Can't do it.
Okay. Well, Wally, I believe David has Johnny Sola cornered next door in the South dressing room, something you'll be trying to do pretty soon. So let's get over and see what Johnny's got to say.
John, it's been your brilliance in the last two matches that's been largely responsible for South being here today. What does winning this match mean to you?
Oh, it means everything to me, David. You know, it's really the highlight of my career, and I've just got to win.
It's been said by a lot of the press and experts around town that Strudwick is the key to Valleys. Can you handle him today?
Oh, sure can, yeah. Yeah, he definitely is the key, but you know, every time I've played him, I've felt myself, I've come out on top, I can do it again.
Well, it's obvious that John Salter is feeling very confident. I'm with Alan Bracken now. How are you feeling at the moment, Alan?
Oh, I'm a little nervous, but I'm not too bad. I'm quite confident in the game, yeah.
Feeling aggressive?
Aggressive, that's right, yeah.
Have you had any thoughts about losing the match?
No, not really. We've come this far. You know, go to the grand final. We're not going to rest here. We want to win the grand final.
Well, that's the feeling of the South back line. And if Malcolm Meninga fires this afternoon, like he did last week with this near try, Valleys could be in trouble.
He got chased by Backer. He sheds Backer. He might score. Oh, no, it's a touch.
My final task in South's dressing room is a somewhat awesome one, face-to-face with South enforcer Dave Brown. Dave, what do you expect out there in the first 10 minutes?
Oh, I think it'll be pretty fiery in the first 10 minutes, Dave, but I think we can handle it.
Will you be going out there with the intention of making it fiery yourselves, or do you expect it from Valleys?
Oh, not really. I think if they want to put on the fire, we'll give them what they want.
As you said, it's going to be pretty tough out there. Have you got any fears at all?
No, not at all.
What about a fear of injury?
No, not really, though.
Losing?
Oh, just a little bit.
Well, that epitomises the feeling in the South's front row. George is with Valley's front rower, Tom Duggan. How does Tom feel at the moment, George?
Tom, this is your first grand final in the front row. You got any fears?
No, George, none at all.
Not even getting physically hurt?
No, you can't think about that day like today.
There's going to be a lot of work in there.
Yeah, I like work.
You do?
More the merrier.
Okay, what about a couple of big busting runs as well?
Oh, yeah, I'll do my part.
It'll be your last game in Brisbane, I believe.
Yeah, that's right, George.
How to finish it?
On a winning note, yep.
And what's in store for next year?
Relaxation, just coming down and watch the football in Brisbane every now and then and watching it on the TV.
Any particular fears of the two front rowers from South?
No, none at all, George. I've struck them before and today I'll be no different than any other time.
Finally, the man in the hot seat, Valley captain coach Russ Strudwick. Russ, any last-minute changes, surprises?
No, mate. The ground's still here. The pace is still here. Everything seems to be okay.
Game plan the same as previous games?
Yeah, I think so.
Still nervous, are you?
Oh, yeah, mate. Not as nervous as what they are, I don't think. We've been here a long time and we've got no problems.
What's it feel like to be the mark man?
I think if South think that way, mate, they might as well not go out in the field.
There's 35,000 people out there, Ross. 5,000 died in the Wool Valley followers and 30,000 people hoping like hell that Valley's going to get beaten. How do you handle that?
No, there's 30,000, there might be 5,000 Valley supporters out there and 30,000 people who really don't care who win as long as they see good football, and mate, we've got the good football, so they'll be on our side.
Okay, Ross, well, that's the inside story from both camps here. One fellow who's been through it all, of course, is Des Morris. Des is up in our commentary box. So let's get up to Des and see what his last minute predictions are.
Well, thanks, George. The atmosphere out here today is electric. Both sides are fairly keen to get into the game. This is the worst part of the grand final, of course, is waiting to get out there. And Valleys, I feel, are a little bit cooler. And South have got their first up nerves. And I just can't wait for the game to start. It should be a really great game. I just can't wait for it to start today.
And here's the Southern Suburbs team taking the field right now. Have a listen to the crowd. Gibson at fullback, Graham and Bracken on the wings, Meninga and Ashton the centres, Keely and Sol of the halves, Archer Ross at lock forward, Weir and Lumby in the second rows, Kellaway and Brown the props, David Gould, who can we look for, David Wright?
Well, George, Alan Bracken and Mick Graham, the two flankers for the try apiece in last weekend's game, will be looking for similar service. And Billy Argeros, the Tigerish little lock, smallest lock forward playing in Brisbane, the tackling machine, They'll be looking for a non-stop performance from Argyros to contain Valley's attacking machine. He'll be looking for something like around about 40 tackles.
Here, there's the Valley side, and they're lining up in centre field. And there's the team, Mills at fullback, Neil and Falvey on the wings, Close and Whelan in the centres, McWhirter and Strubbick the halves, Lewis at lock forward, Sommer and McLeod the second rowers, Duggan and McGinnis the props, and Paul Richards the hooker, of course. David?
Well, look at the Valley's flankman, George. Peter Falvey would be surely the fastest man on the field, well up in the try-scoring list this year, scoring 15 tries in Brisbane. Mick Neil with the goal-kicking responsibilities. He's the top point scorer in Brisbane football with 226 points this year from 101 goals. Not completely at home on the wing, but settling down after a half a dozen or so games. The Valley centre pair, Vic Whelan and Chris Close, probably the biggest and strongest centre pair in Brisbane club football, and their clash with Meninga and Astle should be a highlight of the match.
Okay, the toss has been done, and after this commercial break, we'll come back with the kickoff.
It's on this Sunday from 12 noon, the Warana Food and Wine Festival, sponsored by Diners Club. Great food, good wine, lots of fun, and you're invited. Warana is here again. Great fun and entertainment day and night up to October 7th. The free Warana Liftout program in the Sunday Mail September 16 gives the locations and times of hundreds of events, including concerts, exhibitions and craft displays, dancing, art, drama, rodeo and many other attractions. Join in the fun and enjoy all the free family entertainment. Warana Information Centres are in the City Square, Valley Plaza, Bank of New South Wales, Queen Street, Botanic Gardens and at the Mardi Gras South River Bank. Warana, a special contribution to the International Year of the Child. A bail jumper accused of a $2 million rip-off's murdered aboard ship. The same ship on which Eddie Capra's enjoying his long overdue holiday. Who stabbed the stowaway? What happened to the $2 million? That's the baffling Eddie Capra mystery tonight at 7:30 here on Channel O.
There it goes from Eddie Warden. Valley's had the kickoff. Lewis sends it well downfield. Tony Gibson under the ball for the first touch for Southern Suburbs. As we said previously, a capacity crowd, I'd say all of 35,000 people, and the first penalty goes to Southern Suburbs, and listen to the Southern Suburbs supporters. Whoa!
Well, it's a pro-South crowd, George, as expected. I'd say maybe 90% of the people here this afternoon would love to see the underdog Southern Suburbs get up, and a good opportunity here for South to relieve some pressure. They don't want to be caught down in their own court early in this match. They want to get the ball up inside Valley's territory and play no-mistake football.
Mick Graham in from the wing, grabbed by Tom Duggan and Al McGuinness, and down goes Mick Graham. He's lost the ball, and it's a knock-on. David Gould dives on it, but a knock-on ruled. And the first scrum of the match to pack about 15 metres inside Southern Suburbs territory. And referee Eddie Ward not happy with it. The crowd starting to chant south, you can hear them. Valley ball off the ankle and a knock on as well. So we'll have the first scrum once again. Salter to feed. Richards win this one for Valleys. Lewis is standing up the scrum. Alan Mills. Mills grabbed by Argyros. 10 metres inside Southern Suburbs territory. No score to either side in the 1979 grand final. Strudwick tries the blind side. Sends it back inside to McGuinness, he drops it. Another scrum. Very disappointed, Al McGuinness.
And in back play, Strudwick down, and he was stood up in that tackle to flick the ball back to McGuinness, and a couple of South players came over the top. I don't think they really got to him. Could have been as he hit the ground, because I think Ross just saw them coming and went to the turf fairly quickly.
We may be able to pick it up on our replay. Here it is.
Ross just going to offload the ball, and there come the two South players.
We might be able to shift those streamers in a moment to give us a better view of the game. Strudwick receiving the magic sponge at this present moment.
Well, George, just a look. Here it is from the head on, and there's Strudwick looking around to get the ball. Brown and Gould was coming in over the top, and Strudwick going to the turf fairly quickly.
He's okay. Another scrum to pack. All the streamers to be at Lang Park. There's one right in front of our commentary box, but hopefully it'll blow away fairly soon. It's gone now. Thank you. Southern Suburbs with the ball. A couple of metres inside their own territory. Gould, Salter, Killaway out wide. Runs a Duggan. Finally, Killaway goes to the ground. Salter, Argyros, Astle, Gibson in from fullback, wrapped up immediately. Lumbee on the blind side. Down you go. Good tackle, John McLeod. Salter, long pass. Bracken standing in at 5'8", and Keeley out on the wing. Bracken playing 5'8", and Keeley on the wing in this opening stanza, David.
Yes, an interesting change, George. Bracken certainly the more solid and experienced player than young Chris Keeley. And I would think that Wayne Bennett might be looking at this as for the settling down period, and I wouldn't surprise to see Keeley come back into 5'8 at a later time in the match.
Penalty for Jude Valley from the scrum. Beating their own second row indicated against John Solder.
This kick here would be just at the limit of McNeil's range, I think, George, and Strudwick's decided not to give South any opportunities with possession, and he's decided to go for touch.
Kick from Alan Mills, finding touch. About 6 metres inside the Southern Suburbs quarter. Can Valley score first points in the 79 grand final? Just over 3.5 minutes of play gone. First half, no score to either side. Fortitude Valley, 5 left in this lot of 6. Al McGuinness charging towards the line. Pull down, 3 metres out. 4 left. Stradwick, Duggan. Has no fears, as he told us before the game. Stradwick once again. Ian Summer, Wally Lewis. Lewis back to Stradwick. Gives it out to McQuarter, out to McLeod. Shed Dastel, John McLeod, a strong run. 2 metres out with 2 left in this lot of 6. No score to either side. McQuarter, Stradwick, long one to Mills. Chris Close, Coastal score. Yes, great football, Fortitude Valley. Coastal scored the first try. Valley 3, South still. The first try of the 1979 Grand Final to Fortitude Valley. And a great piece of work from Fortitude Valley. Stradwick dummies McGuinness. There's McGuinness. Goes to Mills. Quick pass. Mills. Close has just pulled in from behind him. They can't catch him. He's too strong and too fast. And Close scores the first try within the first 5 minutes.
Well, South's yet to settle down and Valley's making ground. Good work from Stradwick. He's dictating play already. Mills up into the back line. Nicely to Close. Close does his best to try and drop it. Then accelerates away. And the cover defence can't take him for Valley's first try.
Ominous signs for Southern Suburbs, Des Morris.
Yes, George, they were fairly spread right across the field and they didn't have enough men on this side. The play of the ball was right in the middle of the ruck and Valley's read the game very well and they had too many men out here, that was all there was. And Mel Meninga had about 3 men to take, he just couldn't do it. And Chris Close was over the first try.
Des Morris, our co-commentator this afternoon. McNeil with the breeze across him. Valley's have the breeze at their backs in this first half. And Neil just outside the quarterway and in about 5 metres has kicked 107 goals thus far this season, and today will be the most important goals for 1979. Has to judge the breeze and I think he's judged it. Beautiful kick, and the Valley fans in the outer very happy with that one. They're in the minority, as David said. But Valley's lead 5-0 in the 1979 Grand Final after 6 minutes of play in the first half.
Well, George, as expected in the early stage of this game, it was going to be South who had to settle down. They're the young, enthusiastic side up against the cool professionals of Valley's. And Valley's have looked every bit the cool professionals. Scrums at this stage favour Valley's 2-1 and the penalties are 1-1. Valley's are just very machine-like. There's nothing panicky about their play. Strudwick is just standing around at the moment. He just flicks a pass on here and there, calling all the shots. And here's his first tactical kick. It looks a beauty.
Run towards the line. Keeley's after it. Gibson's got it covered. Knocks it down. Knocked back indicated. And Gibson takes the ball. Takes the tackle about 7 metres outside his own quarter. Southern Suburbs, 7 metres outside their own quarter. Valley's leading by 5-0 in this 79 Grand Final. And of course, you're watching Channel O's Action League. Bob Killaway, crunch and down goes Killaway, 13 metres from the halfway line. David Gould a dummy half, David Brown. very cool when he was talking to you before the game, David.
Yes, he was very fired up for this match. A bad play, the ball, but they've got away with it. Oh. Nothing silly from South required out here today. But David Brown, a good run too to get to that position. He ran straight and hard. South must get their fair share of possession. They've showed us in the last 2 weeks that they can attack. And if they can get enough ball, they could have Valleys in a spot of bother. But Valleys, if they get the ball, I think could really chalk up a big score.
Lumby almost to halfway. David Gould from dummy half. Gains about 8 metres. Pull down. 8 metres inside Fortitude Valley territory. Lumby to distribute. Salter. Argyros out wide. Has Bruce Astle with him. Now to Meninga. Meninga gets to close. Close charges at him. Puts him down on the halfway line. Astle. Argyros. Puts the chip kick in. Taken by Strudwick. Play on indicated. Strudwick grabbed by Mick Graham and put down. 7 metres inside his own territory. Mills. Lewis. Looks for a gap in the middle. Can't find one. 4 metres short of the halfway line. Sommer. Strudwick. John McLeod. Argyros just ankle taps him. Lumby finishes him off. Duggan. Strudwick calling the play once again. Alan Mills. Mills looking for a run. Has Falvey with him. Through the gap. Falvey couldn't get inside quick enough, but a good run from Alan Mills. Mills to play it back. Falvey tries the blind side. Oh, he gives it back to Brian Weir. Weir says thank you. Bob Kellaway can't believe his good fortune. Up the middle goes Kellaway, but he's grabbed by Al McGuinness and Tom Duggan. 18 metres inside their own territory, Southern Suburbs. David Brown. McQuarter underneath. Gould, Salter, Bracken, Astle. Inside to Meninga this time. Breaks one. Gets to McQuarter. Pushes off McQuarter. Lewis comes at him and McQuarter comes back. Ash Lumby from dummy half. And Lumby's down. Strong tackle from Vic Whelan. Lewis takes a swan dive. Oh, beautifully done, McNeil.
Yes, and we're seeing tactical kicking from both sides. McNeil positioned well to take that one from Salter. And we've seen Ross Strudwick do the kicking for Valleys, and this is going to play an important part in the match. Finals are won with no mistakes, and you don't want to play the game in your own territory.
Alan Mills tries to step his way through. Argyros tackles him. Tom Duggan doing the front rower's job. Lumby underneath. Fires it back. Strudwick. Now to Mills. Mills goes back the other way, but wrapped up in the middle. He should have moved at that time, David.
Yes, George, a gap on the out wide, and South is still a little bit thin out in that area. Johnny Salter caught out wide there, and Malcolm Meninga getting caught too close to the ruck, I think, and will have to get back into his centre position where he's going to be of most value.
Just over 10 minutes of play gone first half in this 79 grand final, and Valley's leading South by 5 points to nil. One try. Studley puts the chip in. Lewis is after it. Could get a bounce. Takes it. Finds McQuarter. Now he shoots it inside of Strudwick. He's overrun it. And Meninga has it. And a six to go indicated. They've got it back. They could score again. Sommer. Sommer looks inside. He's 10 metres out. Oh, yeah. Valleys leading by 5 points to nil. And a penalty going to Valleys against Brian Weir.
Second tackle by Weir. Argyros had grounded Sommer nicely. And Weir came over the top and just dived on him on the ground. Here it is again. Sommer's down. About to get up and play the ball, and Weir unnecessarily comes in to finish him off, and Eddie Ward, no hesitation, and neither will Ross Strudwick. Here it is on the end on replay. Down goes Sommer, and there's Weir coming in, trying nothing vicious in it, just trying to slow up the play. But here, McNeil now with an opportunity to add another 2 points.
Des, how do you see the first 11 so far?
Yes, I think South have got to slow down the play a bit. They're getting caught out of position a hell of a lot in defence, and they're not spreading out across the field, and Valleys are making the most of every opportunity they're getting.
Scrums and penalties, David?
Scrums at this stage, George, favouring Valleys 2-1, and the penalties favouring Valleys also 2-1.
OK, McNeil just on the quarter way, about 12 metres in from the terrace touchline, the old terrace touchline. The breeze is non-existent at this present moment. There's the flags on the post just moving, and that's all. And Neil with one out of one to convert the try scored by Chris Close. He's trying to make it 7-0. And a bit of a boo for Neil, but that's all the way. 2-2, McNeil. The Valley supporters have something to cheer about. Valley 7, South 0.
South will be having nightmares at the moment, and Wayne Bennett certainly be one of them. He's had to come from behind in every match in the last three running into this final, and it's very important now that he can his players settle down. There's Wayne Bennett up on the end tower we've got up there, the Rec Air Tower, and he's get a bird's eye view from there as he likes watching the play from behind the behind his own side.
Valleys with the ball just outside their own quarter. Tom Duggan. Des, I don't think that Souths can afford the luxury of giving away a start like they gave you guys last week.
No, not against the sideline Valleys. They're a hard side. They've trained for 2 years for this game today, and by the look of it, they mean business the whole way through.
Ian Sommer, Wally Lewis, a long one out to Peter McQuirter. Ross Strudwick, dummies, gives it now to Alan Mills. Mills is through the gap, looks inside, finds close, but close, jumped upon immediately. Oh, that was a hospital pass, that one, David.
It's down the mine there, and Mills just trying to get rid of it just a little bit too early. I think if he could have gone on with the job, and another kick by Strudwick. Valleys are onside.
Oh, big bounce. Can they get it? Whelan's knocked it on. Fires it back to Wally Lewis, but it's a knock-on. Forwards all Valleys in this first 13 minutes. Valleys leading by 7 points to nil. A try by Chris Close in the fifth minute. Converted by McNeil. And Neil also kicking a penalty goal. A very important scrum here for South. South need to win ball. Scrum's only 2-1 against him, but it's in situations like this where you need the ball, but Valleys have got it. Fortitude Valley in the Southern Suburbs quarter. Alan Mills, Mills does to dance, looks for a gap, can't find one, put down by John Solder. Tom Duggan, Ross Stradwick, Peter McQuirter. Just inside the quarterway. Stradwick, Tom Duggan. Looking for a big one to finish on, as he told us before we started this game. Would like to finish his Brisbane stint with a premiership win. Strudwick, reversing play. Well tackled. Mickey Graham. Not Mickey Graham, Alan Bracken. Up it goes. Gibson takes it. And almost put into the bandstand.
Here it is, the big one from Cape Town. Action replay. Nick Gilder, Kelly Marie, Blondie. Get the action right here with Doug Parkinson, Skyhooks, Dragon. The Babies. Action replay. Available at Meyer, David Jones, Homecrafts, Walton's, Piling, King & King, Dagen, Grimes, Pickett's, Chandler's, Woolworth's largest stores.
It's Bissell Clean Sweep Trade-In Time at Meyer, the easiest way you ever picked up a $5 saving. Trade in any old cleaning aid on a Bissell carpet-caring product, and Meyer give you $5 off. Rush this limited offer and save on the Bissell Gemini Carpet Sweeper, or the Cassette Simple Sweep Easy or 8000R, even the Bissell Foam Master or 9000S Carpet Shampooers. The Bissell Clean Sweep Trade-In at Meyer. Hurry, it's the easiest way you ever picked up a $5 saving.
Later restart from under the goal sticks. Injured player for Fortitude Valley is who, David?
Ian Sommer, George. He went down, looks like a recurrence possibly of that knee injury that he's had quite a few weeks ago.
Alan Mills. Mills dangerous in this situation. Runs straight into big male Meninga, and Meninga hits him with a good shoulder. 15 minutes of play gone in the first half, and Valley's leading by 7 points to nil. McQuirter, dummies. Woo, almost threw a pass off the ground. McLeod, across the ruck, grabbed by Lumbee. Valleys on the Southern Suburbs quarterway. Richards reversing it to Stradwick, and reverses it again to Duggan. Out it goes to Mills this time. A long one over the top, and it's on the ground. Can Southern Suburbs capitalise? Knock-on indicated. Another scrum to pack. Scrum's favouring Valleys 3-1. Penalties favouring Valleys 3-1. in the error situation. Valleys have made four errors to Southern Suburbs one, but Valleys have the score their way, 7 points to nil, 16 minutes of play gone in this, the first half of the 1979 BRL Winfield Grand Final from Lang Park, and you're watching Channel O's Action League. McWhirter, Mills involving himself very much in this first 17 or 18 minutes, David.
Yes, and he's creating that extra man, and South really scrambling back into position. They're yet to settle down. They're not quite as well organised, I'm sure, as Wayne Bennett would like in defence, and Valley's usually making ground. They've had the majority of possession, Valleys. They won scrums 4-1 and penalties are still 2-1. So that's why Valleys have been able to apply all the pressure.
Wally Lewis, the wonder boy, could score himself. Looks for Falvey. No, couldn't get a good pass to him and goes into touch.
Well, I don't know whether Peter Falvey didn't score or Wally Lewis wasn't looking, but there was a try on there. Lewis running across the ruck and Falvey positioned himself perfectly, and there was a short pass to Falvey would surely have eventuated in a try.
Scrum to pack. Bracken back on the wing. Keeley into 5-8 now, David.
Yes,
so
George,
the change has come after the 15th minute. Studwick's ball again. He's lost it. Picked up by Falvey and he's knocked it on. Another scrum to pack. Ball in by John Solder. 5-1 the scrums. Favour Valley. Souths get it when they need it this time. Solder tackled by Studwick. What can Southern Suburbs do with the ball? They haven't had that much of it, David.
No, George, and that's they are basically an attacking side. They've showed some good attack in the last couple of weeks, and if they don't get sufficient ball this afternoon, as I said earlier, I think Valleys will be much too strong for them. Valleys have come into this game really sweeping all before them in the Brisbane competition. They've only lost three games all year, and with this side out in particular, they've only lost one game, and that was to East back on the 27th of April. So it just shows you just how much this side has dominated the competition, and Ross Studwick obviously the key to it. They've scored 113 tries this year to only 66 by South.
Mal Meninga, one player who can turn a game with a blink of an eyelid like he's done many times this year. Only down by 7 points to nil, Southern Suburbs. They need points fairly soon. Straight to Alan Mills, beautifully positioned. Mills gets to Keeley and Keeley puts him down. Sommer seems to be okay. Peter McWhirter. McWhirter taking it up like a forward. Valley's about 18 metres inside Southern Suburbs territory. Duggan, Lewis, Wally Lewis, and John McLeod. Sommer this time. Studwick has Lewis in support, puts the kick in for him. Through goes Lewis and Falvey. Gibson's there, taken Tony Gibson, and tackled Wally Lewis. And dragged inside the in-goal area.
Well done, Lewis, and Studwick and Lewis, the two players around the base of the ruck that Valleys rely a lot of their attack on, and Lewis was well aware Studwick was going to put that ball in the air. There he is, wonder boy Wally Lewis.
And he was right on the effects of the heat already, David. A very hot afternoon.
It is very hot, George, and this is something that Valleys are going to have to be very wary of. They'll be hoping that they've trained hard enough in the last month, because they've only played one game in the last 4 weeks leading up to this match. South have had a couple of real hard ones, and there's nothing wrong with South's fitness.
Alan Mills, put down by Bob Kellaway. Falvey at dummy half. Ian Sommer, back to Tom Duggan. Duggan just on the Southern Suburbs quarterway. Sommer, Studwick, John McLeod. McLeod, a strong run. Keeley has him. He gets the ball away. Astle stole it. And Astle lost it again, so we'll have another scrum.
And possession too valuable for South to be fritting away like that. A bad pass there for Astle to get the ball, and he loses it immediately. There's six tackles gone down the drain.
And we're halfway through the first half. Solder gives it to Tony Gibson. Gibson put down on his own quarterway. Astle from dummy half. Mills is up there. He busts off Mills. Busts off McGuinness. Gets to McLeod. Good run, Bruce Astle. Gained about 16 metres. McLeod chanting for South. The try now is what they need. Dave Brown. Brown above Kellaway. Kellaway, 3 metres short of the halfway line. Valley's leading by 7 points to nil. Johnny Solder. Solder inside of Meninga. Meninga dummies one. Can he break away? He can't. Valley's having, but Souths are on the rampage about 20 metres inside Fortitude Valley territory. Can Southern Suburbs score? Out it goes. Argyros, Keeley. Keeley steps. Back inside, pull down, fires it to Bob Kellaway. Kellaway fires it to Dave Brown. Brown gets to Sommer, fires it back to Johnny Salter. Salter looking for support but put down on the last tackle coming up. Salter to play the ball 15 metres inside Fortitude Valley territory. Will they put it up or won't they? Weir, long one to Meninga. Can he break him? Inside, picked up. Let go. Eddie Ward was in position with that one. Kellaway get away and good Fortitude Valley.
Defence by Valleys, but South just and what they can do, and Meninga in the times, and he's obviously the danger man. Salter in there, and South can get a bit of... They could have Valleys in trouble.
Scrum to pack 20 metres in Valley territory. They've won another ball, Southern Suburbs. Billy Argyros tries to brush off Wally Lewis. He nearly did. Lewis hangs on. 20 metres inside Fortitude Valley territory. Away goes Chris Keeley. Keeley pulled down about 3 metres inside the quarter. Valley's leading by 7 points to nil. Can Southern Suburbs score? Long one. Bruce Astle. Astle on the quarter wave. Southern Suburbs chance to attack now. Valley's will have to defend. The 79 Premiership, 22 minutes old. And Alan Bracken pulled down. Valley's leading by 7 points to nil. David Gould. Dummies Argyros. Dummies everybody. David Brown finishes with it towards the line. Put down 10 metres out. This is the last tackle. David Gould has a go to Alan Bracken. Bracken! Pull down. Not in a touch, but only about 2 precious metres from the line. Yes, Des?
This close looks as if he's injured the shoulder at this stage.
You're right. Close favouring his left shoulder. And being assisted at this present moment. Lumbee's gone off and Connell's on. Lumbee off, Connell on and Lewis down. So we'll see what referee Eddie Ward is going to do. It looks like the ambulance man will be coming on for Wally Lewis, but we've had the change. There's Connell, number 10, stretching the hamstrings, and we'll see what the magic of Mal Connell can do. I surmise this is the best time to bring him on, David, when Souths are down there in Valley's quarter.
Yes, George, the game not going with Souths at the moment, only points-wise, because they've showed with the ball they can attack well. I would suggest here, too, that there's not a great deal wrong with Wally Lewis. I think they're just giving themselves time to see just how bad Chris Close is. Wally Lewis just happened to go down in the middle of the scrum and therefore the scrum couldn't be packed. Close is up now and it seems that Wally Lewis is up soon after him.
Miraculous recovery from Wally Lewis on that occasion. But gamesmanship at its best, and that's how grand final to won and lost, David.
Oh, my word, George. You cannot afford to go down with a man short with a scrum being packed that close to the line. And very good tactics, really.
Peter McQuirter. McQuirter about 10 metres from his own line. Valley's leading by 7 points to nil. Ian Sommer. Stradwick, McGuinness on the run. Connell takes him down. Paul Richards, almost through. Billy Argyros hanging on by one fingernail.
And he had to too, because Richards could have gone a long way there.
Stradwick's kick, running for touch. Gibson across and has it covered. Well done, Tony Gibson. Got Falvey to beat. Beats Falvey easily. Gets to Duggan. Beats Duggan and scrambles an extra 2 or 3 metres. Good run, Tony Gibson. Graham at dummy half. Likes to run from there. And runs into some Valley defence on this occasion. There's the crowd and their South chant. Have a listen to them. And the penalty goes South's way as well. John Salter to kick for touch. Valley's leading by 7 points to nil. Coming up 24 minutes of play in this first half. Mal Connell is on. Lumbee is off. Bracken has reverted back to his wing position. He played the first 15 minutes at 5'8". And Keeley's back at 5'8". So Wayne Bennett using every available trick in the book, David.
Yes, George, and he'll want to too, because South, although they're settling down somewhat now, Valley's still seem to be in command. And it's going to be his top players, such as Meninga and Astle, that are going to win or lose this game for him this afternoon.
Mickey Graham, Southern Suburbs. Graham's almost through. Southern Suburbs on the attack. 25 minutes of play gone. First half. Valley's leading by 7 points to nil. Mal Connell, the pocket dynamo, as they call him. David Brown says, I'll have a run. Run he does, gains 10 metres, fires it back. How did he do that? Connell to Solder. Solder dances to a gap. Could he score? Fires it inside. Callaway, they're keeping it alive. Connell again, out to Astell. Astell has to straighten up. Does, can he get it away? He can to Argyros. Argyros pull down. All desperate stuff from both sides. Great football, Des Morris.
That's right, George. They're certainly keeping the ball alive. And they're throwing everything at Valleys, and that's the only way to bust them up.
But Bob Callaway knocks on the final tackle. But there's a lot of football left in this game yet. The grand final, 26 minutes of play gone, and Valleys leading by 7 points to nil. You're watching Channel O's Action League. Studbeck to feed this scrum. How are the scrums, David?
George, the scrum's favouring Valleys 6-4. Penalties 2-2.
Ball in by Ross Studbeck. Big push on. And the scrum coming down. David Gould underneath it. Subject to feed the ball once again. Just inside his own quarter. In it goes. Valley ball from this scrum. Alan Mills. Mills gives it now to Vic Whelan. Whelan breaks one. Has Falvey with him. Can he get it to him? Falvey going inside. Couldn't get the ball. Whelan not effectively held. Play on indicated. And Whelan about 6 metres inside the Southern Suburbs territory. Falvey to Tom Duggan. Up the middle goes Duggan. Pull down 20 metres inside Southern Suburbs territory now. Imperative at this stage, David, that Southern Suburbs keep Valleys out with a score 7-0 against them.
Oh, yes, George. They can't afford to let Valleys score points now. But they're having trouble containing Valleys when in possession. And Whelan, I thought, made a mistake there, waiting for his support. Instead of letting the support catch him, he just seemed to be idling along, whereas if he'd really put on the pace, could have made a lot more damage.
Trouble here for Southern Suburbs. Lewis to Mills. There's men over. Mills to Whelan's dropped it and regained it. Scrum to pack for the knock-on. A couple of chances gone begging there for Valleys, Des.
That's right, George. It's a case of having too many men there at that moment. And there's Vic Whelan. If he hadn't have been there, I think Felby might have been a chance of going with a straight pass from Mills.
Typical Aussie morning on a typical Aussie day, and I love this place I was born in a typical Aussie way. And I'd sure hate to lose our sunshine, but I feel it slipping away, and we're gonna have to wake up sometime that everything is not okay. Have a go. We can do it, have a go, we'll come through it, that's how we got the country started. Boots and all and not half-hearted, let's all climb that mountain, that's what mountains are for. Let's all stand up for the counting, where we can be is worth working for. Go. You can do it, have a go, we can do it.
Venus sunglasses are available at Meyer, David Jones, Reeds of Ipswich and all leading pharmacies.
Ball in by John Solder. The scrum about 7 metres inside Southern Suburbs quarterway. And Souths win the ball again when they need it. Shudwick grabs Solder. Mal Connell. Played at 6 to go. Connell fires it back to Argyros. Out it goes to Chris Keeley. Keeley steps back inside. Well done. Shudwick coming from behind. just inside their own quarter, Southern Suburbs. Kellaway, Connell, long one to Meninga. Meninga gives it now to Bracken. Bracken comes infield, fires it back to Astell. Good football, Southern Suburbs. They've taken the ball within 15 metres of the halfway line. Valley's leading by 7 points to nil. There's about 12 minutes left in the first half. Connell fires it back. Meninga got it finally. It looked like a suspect forward pass from here, but let go. Gould, Weir, Salter, Keeley out wide. Gibson's there. Gives it to Graham. Could Graham beat Falvey? Falvey hangs on. Bit of help there from Strudwick. Graham to play it back. Tony Gibson, David Brown. Brown tries to push off McQuirter. McQuirter hangs on. Last tackle coming up for Southern Suburbs. Salter, Argyros. Bruce Astell onto a beautiful pass. He comes infield. Southern Suburbs on the run again. Mal Connell brushes off one. Back to Argyros. Out it goes to Bracken. Bracken comes back infield. Can't get the ball away this time. That was the last tackle. And the scrum to pack about 8 metres inside Fortitude Valley territory.
Well, South, as they said, as their pre-match plan was to move the ball, and they're certainly doing that, and it's finding Valley's having to do a lot of cover defending. They're not being able to contain South in that first up movement, and then they're relying on the cover defence of Strudwick, who's doing a lot of work coming across field, and Wally Lewis is having to come out of his cover defending position, actually, and move up into the front line because gaps are being left because they're having trouble getting back into position fast enough from this fast-moving South attack.
Valley ball once again. By golly, I think Valleys have had more ball in this grand final than they've had in any game for the whole year. Scrum's going their way, 8-5 at this stage. Strudwick, McQuirter, Mills, quick passing, wheel under close. Close has got Falvey with him this time. Close having a big run, but pulled down by Johnny Soler in great cover defence. Good work, Johnny Soler. Falvey, Strudwick, McQuirter, Sommer on the burst, straight up, takes the tackle. 6 metres short of the Southern Suburbs quarterway. Valley's on the run again. Now it goes to Big Al McGuinness. McGuinness fires it back to McQuirter. McQuirter looks for the gap, gives it, no, thought he passed it to Richards. He did. Finally he did. Richards, a good run. About 7 metres inside Southern Suburbs territory. A quick pass will score a try. Out it goes, a long one to Whelan. Lewis. Lewis goes over, close his head. Falvey, they can still score. Falvey, ball in both hands, looks inside. Put down. Good football, Falvey, not allowing himself to go into touch. Last tackle coming up, he plays it forward, looks for support now, but pulled down about a metre short.
Valley's with opportunities and they're letting them fritter by. They've had a couple of chances to score tries on this left-hand side with South's defence shot to pieces, and it's been a couple of bad passes or mishandling that's let them down. They've made errors 7-2, and that's unlike Valley's, mainly because I think they've had that much ball.
South's ball this time. Des Morris, the main reason probably is that these overlaps are coming is because of Alan Mills' involvement, do you think?
Yes, I think he's living in the line a little bit too much and taking out the surprise element. The thing that amazed me a bit about South, they're not using the left wing where they've got McNeil against them, which would probably be the weakest link in Valley's side as far as his wing play goes. Not as a footballer, he's a very good footballer, but as far as a winger goes, he just isn't used to playing there. And just a few times, I thought if they let the ball do the work out there and use a bit of pace that they have got out there, they might have done a bit more with it.
It's going that way now, but it comes back inside to Meninga. Meninga grabbed, held up, 15 metres short of halfway. Last tackle, David Gould from dummy half. Gould pushes off McQuirter, gives to Meninga, fires at the solar. Can they find a space? Back to Billy Argyros. Argyros finally put down. And the scrum to pack for the final tackle. About 17 metres inside Southern Suburbs territory. Seven of the Valley players have played for Queensland, and five of the Southern Suburbs players are Queensland representatives, so plenty of experience out there in both sides. Penalty going to Fortitude Valley. And of course, McNeil will kick for goal. The players in the Valley side that have played for Queensland, Alan Mills, Chris Close, Peter McQuirter, Ross Strudwick, Wally Lewis, John McLeod and Tom Duggan. And the Queensland reps in the Southern Suburbs lineup, Meninga, Astell, Soler, Kellaway and Brown. So there's plenty of experience in both sides, and there's only four players out of the Valley lineup that didn't play in the grand final against Eastern Suburbs last year, and I speak of Chris Close, and Jared Fitzpatrick was in the centre last year. Mark Zillman and Trevor Johnson were in the forwards, and this year Ian Sommer and Paul Richards have replaced them. There's about 8 minutes of play remaining in this first half. What would Wayne Bennett be thinking of now, do you think?
He'd be worried about the points they are behind, and to make sure that they didn't give any more points behind, away in the first half. They're going to have the wind with them in the second half, but it's not a big wind. I mean, you get down on the ground level, and I think he'd be trying to minimise the points against him at this stage. There's not much he can do up in the stand there. He's just got to hope the players can do it, doesn't he?
That's right. He's left his rec air stand and he's gone to the dressing rooms. There's about 8 minutes of play left in the first half. McNeil, it might sneak over. It does. It hardly got further than crossbar height all the way. But 3 out of 3 to McNeil. And 9 points to 0. Valley leading Souths with about 8 minutes of play remaining in the first half, David.
George, I think what Wayne Bennett will be able to say to his players at halftime is that they've done it before. They've come from behind before in matches. He'd obviously still like to see them get points late in this first half and cut down that deficit of 9 points at the moment, which is a fairly massive one in a grand final. But it looks like Valleys have decided now that they're going to play the game down the other end of the field in a long kick by Mills. They'll be looking now to contain South down inside their own territory.
Well, it was exactly 6 minutes of play left in the first half last week when Eastern Suburbs led by a very comfortable margin of 14-0, but at half-time was 14-8. So let's see what Southern Suburbs can do in this final 6 minutes. Chris Keeley making a fist of it, pulled down just inside Valley territory. Can Southern Suburbs score points before half-time? I'm sure every man in that team is aware of it. Bruce Astle, the captain, would be put down now with the ball. 3 metres inside Valley territory. David Gould running from dummy half. Gives it back to Mal Connell. David Brown. Brown looks for support, finds Argyros. Argyros put down 20 metres inside Fortitude Valley territory. On the last tackle, David Gould, John Sola, Mal Connell. Connell into the attack. Out it goes through Meninga. Picked up by Bracken. He's lost it. Regained it. Play on indicated. Infield he comes and put down. That was the last tackle. And a scrum to pack about 9 metres inside the Fortitude Valley territory.
Valley's defence is covering well. They are not always getting to that first tackle, but there's always other players there to support them. And South's attack getting a little bit frustrated. And we saw that long pass from Connell not going to hand.
South's pushing. Can Johnny Sola get it? Penalty against Fortitude Valley for collapsing the scrum. And at 9 points to 0, with 5 minutes of play remaining in the first half, what is Bruce Astle going to do? Sola is going to kick for touch.
Well, I would have had a shot for goal, George. I think well within Meninga's range. But Astle decided a couple of times against East last week to take the tap when he was well outside the one-point try margin. So let's see if it comes off for him, because Salter scored his first try last week of a similar situation.
5 left in this lot of 6. Can Southern Suburbs score before half-time? Valley's lead by 9 points to 0. Mal Connell. Connell breaks a couple of tacklers. By golly, he's a strong young fellow. 8 metres out. Connell to play the ball. Back to Gould. Salter. Keeley. Astle. Put down. 12 metres out now. Southern Suburbs needing points before the halftime hooter. Weir, having a go himself. Gets to McQuarter. McQuarter puts him down. Still 9 metres from scoring. Argyros goes to dummy half. Argyros inside to David Brown. Brown back the other way to Johnny Sola. Sola put down on the last tackle now. They'll have to try the bomb, I think, David.
Yes, George, it'll be a good tactic because they're not getting...
No, they haven't. Argyros by himself. Astelec keeping it alive as much as they can, but Southern Suburbs can't put that elusive try on thus far into the game. About 3.5 minutes of play remaining in the first half, and Valleys leading by 9 points to 0. Scrums favouring Valleys. 8-6. An important one for Southern Suburbs here. Ball in by Stradwick. Penalty again to Southern Suburbs. Much closer this time. There's Valley captain, coach and halfback Ross Stradwick shaking his head. And it looks like Meninga will kick for goal this time. He's talking about the Valley side. Of course, this time last year they were doing battle with the Eastern Suburbs Tigers. And what a valiant game that was. Des Morris will never forget it. Down 10 points to 9 with 5 minutes of play remaining. And home come the Tigers, Des.
Home they come, that's right. Pity they couldn't do it last week, George.
Valley's last premiership win was in 1974 in one of the only grand finals played in Brisbane. where there was no tries scored at all. 9-2, Valleys beat Brothers. All goals and field goals. Two penalty goals and a field goal to Ross Strudwick, a penalty goal to John Crilly, and two field goals to Alan Mills. And Mills and Strudwick, the only two survivors from that 74 team. But Big Al McGuinness had number 16 on his back that day. Henry Holloway was the coach of Valleys and Paul Broughton the coach of Brothers. On that occasion, Mal Meningar. It looks good. No goal. No goal. Valleys still lead by 9-0 with precious little time left in this first half. Just stay with us during the half-time break because we'll be looking at the highlights of the first half. And also David Wright and Des Morris will be reviewing the first half and looking at what may happen in the second half. Tony Gibson. Kellaway. Strong run, Big Bob Kellaway. On the halfway line. McGuinness trying to wrench his leg off. Solder. Astle. Back inside. Thinks he sees a gap, and by golly, he almost did. 2 metres inside Fortitude Valley territory. Argyros. Mal Connell. Back inside to Keeley. Keeley wrapped up. Only one try in it. Close scored the first try and the only try. 5 minutes into the first half. David Brown. Around goes Brian Weir. Last tackle coming up. Meninga from dummy half. Argyros. Back inside. It's on the ground. Picked up by David Gould. David Brown. Connell. Solder. Bracken. Richards out there. Fires it inside to Astle. Southern Suburbs keeping the ball alive at every available opportunity. Mal Meninga receiving some attention, and this should be the last scrum of the first half.
George, in the defensive department, as expected, players who were going to chalk up tackles have, but a real shock of the match has been Al McGuinness. He's chalked up 17 tackles. McWhirter, 17, the tackling machine for Valleys, has only got the same as Big Al McGuinness. And Billy Argyros, South's tackling machine, has got 18.
Argyros with the ball now. Half-time, precious seconds away. There it is. Referee Wart heard it. John Solar back inside of Mal Connell. Can they score after the bell? Connell, out it goes to Argyros, to Bracken. He looks inside. He's away inside the corner. Lewis is after him. Mills is after him. He lost the ball. Oh, what a way to end the first half. Valleys lead at half-time by 9-0. Bracken can't believe it. Valleys 9, South 0. After this commercial break, back with the highlights of the first half. And a talk with Des Morris and David Wright.
I'm singing in the rain.
J&B Records just presents Doris Day. 20 golden greats.
Que sera, sera.
A fantastic collection. Que sera, sera. A guy is a guy. Getting to know you. Teacher's pet.
Teacher's pet.
All your favorites. Lullaby of Broadway. Pillow Talk. Please don't eat the daisies.
Please, please don't eat.
High Hopes, Windy City, the lovely Secret Love.
Once I had a secret.
The one and only Doris Day. Love Me or Leave Me, Black Hills of Dakota.
Take me back to the black.
For the first time on one LP, 20 glorious songs from the golden girl of Hollywood.
Everybody loves.
They're all here. Zippity doodah.
Zippity doodah.
Doris Day, 20 golden greats available right now at the special TV price of just $6.99 from record stores everywhere.
World Travel Headquarters, the Women's Weekly Tour People, bring you Swing Away Asia Holidays. Swing Away Asia gives you the best in itineraries, the best dollar value, shows you more and cares for you more than anybody else. Swing Away Asia gives you all first-class hotels and air-conditioned coaches. Swing Away Asia flies Qantas. Get this brochure then.
Swing Away.
Okay, half-time of the 1979 BRL Winfield Grand Final. Of course, Valleys leading by 9-0. A try by Chris Close, converted by McNeil. Two penalty goals kicked by McNeil. Mal Meninga has one shot at penalty goal, was unsuccessful. But what a tough first half, David Wright.
Well, yes, George, and I think Valleys would be well satisfied with it because they've got the points on the board at 9-0. They've been making ground in attack. They've had some good variation, and their defence has been able to hold out some good attack from South. South didn't settle down early, and that was a problem that we thought they might have because they are a fairly young side. But they have settled down somewhat and been able to hold Valleys out in the latter part of the first half and create some errors that we haven't normally seen from Valleys. The error count's 7-2, so Valleys making the mistakes. There's a lot more football left in this game yet because South has shown that they can attack. And if they put a little bit more variety into it, not just keeping the ball alive, but running hard, they could still get back into this match, but it's very important they get points on early in the second half.
Des Morris, your thoughts?
Yes, George, I think what Dave said is pretty right. They're not running in the fours, they're not taking the ball to the defence, they're content to just throw it around. And while they're not making any inroads into the Valley's defence, they're not fixing up the straight line defence, they're not busting that up at all. Until you start busting aside and putting them on the back pedal, then you're not really gaining anything. I think a few of those South blokes, they've come out today and seen 35,000 people looking at it for the first time, and obviously had a few jitters early, but I think they've settled down now. And with a little bit of luck and I think a bit more hard running by the forwards, I think they can still come back. Valley's come out as a side who was looking for football after 2 weeks layoff, and they performed that way for the first 20 minutes. They've now settled down and they're probably, if anything, a bit over keen with Alan Mills. He's trying to do too much in attack, and but they're still throwing the ball around, and when they have got the ball, they're making a fair bit of yardage.
Dennis, do you think that's the reason why they're making the mistakes? Just too much ball and too many people there?
I think that's about it. I think that they've had a lot of ball. They nearly had all the first half until the last five or 10 minutes. But I think they'll settle down at half time and probably start off again like they did in the first half.
So what's the finish in the second half?
I think Valleys have to win it.
David, back to you, and what do you think?
Well, yes, sir, I think Valleys will go on with it. I'm sure Ross Strudwick in the dressing room there now will be just saying that if South don't score, we win the match. They've got the points on the board there. I'd say we're going to see even tighter defence from Valleys in the second half, and it's going to be very hard to see South chalking up points. But South have come back every time, and that's what Wayne Bennett will be saying. Look, we can do it, we can do it. We've come back before, and that's the message he'll be trying to get across to his young goers. Whether they can or not remains to be seen.
Okay, well, of course, the first try was scored by Chris Close. A very good opening stanza from Fortitude Valley, and his closest try once again in slow motion. You can see the dummy pass McGuinness to Alan Mills. Mills, a quick pass, and Chris Close pulls it in from behind him and dives over the line down for the Fortitude Valley first try. They led 3-0 after 5 minutes, and here it is from end on, the long pass, Mills. There it goes behind him, he pulls it in, you can see the white line, and Close in for the first try. That's the only try of the first half, and of course there was a near try near half-time, or after the half-time hooter as a matter of fact, which was almost scored by Alan Bracken. Here it is, Southern Suburbs in a bit of a quandary, not knowing which way to go. Solar fires it back, the half-time hooter has gone at this stage of the game. Mal Connell refuses to die with it, fires a long one out to Billy Argyros. Argyros out to Bracken, and Bracken does very well. Dummies goes inside, gets inside the quarter, runs very hard. Lewis comes across, dives at him. Mills is there, and just as well Mills was there, but Bracken had lost the ball anyway, and that was the near try. Here it is from the head-on. Once again, as I said, Southern Suburbs in a bit of a mess there after the hooter had gone. That's switching it around. Mal Connell doesn't know which way to go. He says, I'll try this side. Argyros, and as I said, Bracken does good work. Dummies, Neil takes the dummy. Away he goes. Mills has got him covered. Lewis has got him covered. But as he reaches, he loses the ball. And that was the closest that Southern Suburbs got to scoring a try in the first half. And as I said, it happened just as the half-time hooter had sounded. Okay, that's it for the first half. After this commercial break, back with all the action of the second half, the 1979 Winfield BRL Grand Final. Second half underway. Mal Meninga takes the kickoff. And McNeil has the ball. It looks like there's no changes to either side during the half-time break. Chris Close is still there. Some of the players that were slightly injured during the first half will look for. Meninga's still there. Graham's still there. Yes, there's no changes to either side. And 40 minutes of furious football left for this 1979 BRL Winfield Grand Final Premiership Cup. Tom Duggan. Duggan 20 metres inside his own territory. Richards on the last tackle, 15 metres short of halfway. McGuinness, Strudwick, Vic Whelan. Whelan looking for support. John McLeod, my memory serves me right, Des. Last year, Vic Wieland really hit his straps in the first 10 minutes of the second half.
That's right, George. He went very well in the grand final last year, and he was the man that nearly pulled the game out of the bag for them. But he's having a quieter game today. They seem to be turning him back inside a little bit and stopping him from getting his ball to his supports outside.
First scrum win to Fortitude Valley. Look how flat those back lines are, David. They're almost shaking hands with each other.
Yes, George, and they've been doing it all day, and neither side wanting to give the other one any latitude at all to be able to attack from the scrum base. And just from what we've seen in the first 2 minutes of this second half, Valleys are obviously going to tie this game up and try and play it very safe. They've run about four or five times in the previous six tackles from dummy half. They haven't been prepared to kick possession away to South. And there goes Johnny McLeod again from dummy half. So South will have to be aware of this. They want to start playing a double marker if necessary. And what's the centre of the ruck?
Alan Mills in. Vic Wieland. Wieland back to Alan Mills. Steps one. Fires it to Wally Lewis on the burst. Lewis is away. Gives it back to Close, but Close has dropped it. Southern Suburbs ball. Mick Graham with the ball. And Graham just outside the quarterway by about 3 metres. Southern Suburbs with the ball. Just outside their own quarterway. Valleys led at half-time by 9 points to nil. Valleys 9, South 0. Second half about 2 minutes old. David Gould tries his luck from dummy half. Gains about 10 metres. Connell. Salter, long torpedo punt kick, Neil's there, has a sun in his eyes, taken well McNeil, beats Meninga, but doesn't beat Astle. Meninga slightly injured, attempting the tackle. John McLeod, McLeod right on halfway. Sommer, McQuarter, Strudwick to Mills, gap out there for Whelan. Close on the burst. Well tackled. Good tackle, David, that one.
Good tackle there from Keeley. And Keeley has been a player that, when he came into the 5-8 position in the first half, did cause Valley's defence some deal of trouble. He's got a nice, neat little step. And he hasn't been overawed, this young fellow, by the occasion this afternoon.
Wally Lewis breaks one. What a footballer this fellow is, Des.
He's got a great pitch, George. He can do anything, and he's a good defender. Kicks well, does everything.
Attempted field goal from Ross Strudwick, but dropped short under the crossbar. No points. Valley still lead by 9 points to nil. And play to restart from the quarterway.
I think Ross Strudwick would be very keen to get more than the two converted tries away, George, at 9-0 at the moment. If South can score, then they're right in this match. But if Ross can get a penalty or get that one pointer over that he was attempting for, I think South would find it very hard psychologically to fight on in this match.
Room to move now. Keeley's through the gap. Meninga looming on his outside. What a tackle. Wally Lewis. A penalty. What for?
Penalty there going for John McLeod, impeding Mal Meninga to get into position. We can see that again on the replay. Showed out very clearly a professional foul by McLeod. And he was no way going to catch Keeley. So he had to do something about stopping Meninga. There's Meninga in the bottom of the screen. And McLeod's the fella right next to him now. There's the close-up of Keeley. He's gone through the gap nicely. Determination on his face. He's sprinting hard.
As a look, but unfortunately
we haven't got it on camera, but that was certainly what it was for.
Changed camera angles that we just took off at the split second when McLeod was going to put him on the deck. Southern Suburbs need the points early in the second half, as David said. 5 minutes of play gone second half. Valley's leading by 9-0. The 1979 BRL Winfield Premiership in the balance. And of course you're watching all the action on Channel O's Action League. The crowd chanting South, South, and away goes Big Bob Kellaway. Souths are inside the quarterway. Down by 9 points to nil. Can they score the try to get back in this game? Argyros around goes Gould. Whoa, a bit of a mix-up and a Valley ball. People going everywhere, a Valley ball. McQuarter runs it up like a forward and gains about 12 metres in the effort. Well, their rehearsed moves coming undone at the wrong times, Des.
That's right, they had two on there in a row, and that was probably a bit adventurous for them. The first one worked well, but the second one, I think if they just got quick hands, they might have been better served.
Richards, 7 metres short of halfway. Duggan, back to nobody, but picked up by Sommer. Strudwick, McQuarter, Stoppy goes around him, and Southern Suburbs ball this time. Weir, Mal Connell, long pass again to Meninga. Comes infield, wrapped up, swarmed upon, jumped upon and put down by Whelan and Close. Keeley from dummy half, fires it back to Gould. Hella goes to Sola. Sola to Astle, got a gap. Hella goes to Bracken, confronted by McNeil. Neil puts him down. 7 metres short of the Valley Quarterway. Southern Suburbs with the ball. Astle goes around Sola. Oh, and he got through. I thought Tommy Duggan was going to shift the position of his left ear there for a minute, David.
Well, he did his best to do it, and he was very lucky not to get away without being penalised. And South showing some good attack early in the second half, but Valley's defence up to it at the moment.
Keeley steps, wrapped up, scrum to pack on the Valley Quarterway. Only one scrum second half that's gone to Valley's. They have the scrums their way, 9-7. And there's only one penalty that's gone Southern Suburbs' way. They have the penalties their way, 5-3. Both back lines standing very flat. Valley's had the ball. Strudwick to Lewis. Lewis put down. 17 metres short of the halfway line. Ian Sommer. Mal Connell, the tackler. Al McGuinness. Loves to run. Fires it back to Alan Mills. Mills, just inside the Southern Suburbs half. Neil. McQuarter. McLeod. McLeod trying to struggle, a hands free, fires one over the top. Close has it, play on indicated. Graham has hold of Close, and he puts him down. 7 metres inside Southern Suburbs territory. Valley still leading by 9 points to nil. That was a half-time score. And about 8 minutes of play gone into this second half. Richards, Studwick, delays the pass to John McLeod, to Bruce, to Peter McQuarter, Al McGuinness. McGuinness, back to McLeod. McLeod, can he get it away? Finally loses it. Bracken has it for Southern Suburbs.
Well, Valley's just trying a little bit too hard to get that pass away. McLeod had an opportunity there to slip it the first time, didn't slip it, and then elected to try a desperation one. And Valleys don't need to get desperate. They've got the points on the board. They have to let South make all the mistakes and take all the risks.
Very critical stage of the game for both sides. Coming up to 10 minutes of play into the second half. Valleys have the lead of 9 points to nil. They've got to hang on to it, and Southern Suburbs know that they've got to get points on the board. Kellaway to play the ball, back to David Gould. John Sola, left foot kick for touch on the grandstand side. Falvey chases it, but he can't catch it. Good kick, Johnny Sola. And even though scrums are against him, 10-7, that was the tactics, I feel, Des.
That's right, they've got to play the game in Valley's half, that's for sure. They don't seem to have enough confidence in their centres. They're taking a long time to get the ball out to their centres, and I think they've got one of the best pair of centres in town, and I think if they use it out wider, they might make a few more clean breaks.
Ball in by Stradwick. Valley's lead by 9 points to nil. That was the half-time score. No changes to either side during the half-time break. Only one change in the first half in the Southern Suburbs lineup. Valley's win the ball again. Lumby was replaced by Connell in the 22nd minute of the first half. Valley's going on with it. Quick passing, McQuarter. They're overrunning themselves. A long pass, it could be an intercept. Bracken has it. Can South capitalise? Bracken getting up very slowly. Argyros, Mick Graham from the other wing. Graham across field, looks for a gap, breaks one, inside the quarter, put down, 3 metres inside the quarter. Can Southern Suburbs score? Valley's lead by 9 points to nil. 10 minutes of play gone in the second half. Solda, Mal Connell, Connell to Astle. Astle has Gibson inside, but Mills has hold of Astle. And down goes the Southern Suburbs skipper. About 5 metres inside Valley Quarterway. Gibson, Bob Kellaway, the big fellow, ducks under one, put down, 10 metres out. David Gould from dummy half, dummies to everybody. Argyros, Argyros, can he sneak his way through? Not while Peter McQuarter's there. Last tackle coming up for Southern Suburbs. No points on the board, down by 9 points to nil. Solder's kick is in the air. All Souths are onside. Can they score from the bomb? No, it's out over the dead ball line and play to restart from under the goal sticks. That's the brightest piece of play we've seen from southern suburbs, David.
Yes, George, they're putting it together, and a good bomb by South, and that'll allow them to keep on the pressure. And Valley's flagging just a little bit. There's Ross Strudwick trying to encourage them on. It's a very hot afternoon, and as we've said, Valley's have played one game in 4 weeks, and this will be the time now that they'll start feeling it if they haven't done enough work in that period of 4 weeks. We know South are going to run on.
Drop out by Mills. McGraham. Straight through goes McGraham. Can he beat Lewis? No, he can't. And Lewis puts him in a touch. Lewis is saying a few well-chosen words to those men in front of him. Can you see that lot, David?
Well, he might, because I think Wally was having a little bit of a spell out the back, and he found himself having to do a bit of work. And I would think that Valleys and Strudwick will not be very happy at all with this lapse that the side's going through at the moment. But South must get points on the board. If Valleys are in a lapse, they'll come out of it pretty quick, because they're too professional to stay in it for too long. So while they're in there, South must get the points that are on offer.
South ball from the scrum. Johnny Sola. Five left in his start of six. Can Southern Suburbs score points? Gibson in from fullback. Good tackle. Vic Will in the tackler. Meninga. Keeley. Can step. Decides to run. Good run. 10 metres out. Alan Bracken from dummy half. One can feel a try coming for Southern Suburbs. Connell. Back to Argyros. Argyros tries to dance his way through. Can't do so. Two left in his start of six. Pressure mounting for Fortitude Valley. David Gould from dummy half. Can he score? I think he's in. No. Last tackle coming up. Southern Suburbs need the points. Down by 9 points to nil. Argyros. Brian Weir. Weir. Lost the ball. Oh. Vic Whelan with the ball. What's your gut feeling at this stage, Des Morris?
Well, South are certainly taking it to Valleys, but they're still refusing to get the ball out to Meninga. And I think if you can play with that much ability in the side, you've got to make the most of him, and I don't think they are. And they're trying to bust Valleys in the forwards. I don't think that's where the gap's going to come.
You think Valleys can last the distance?
Yeah, well, it's a bit early to say, isn't it, George, really. It's South. It's been all South in the second half. It's been in their half for the whole 10 minutes, 12 minutes.
Valleys with the ball. Strudwick. John McLeod. Final tackle. And the scrum to pack. Once again a vital scrum, and Ross Strudwick is really laying down the law to his troops. Coming up to 14 minutes of play gone, second half. 26 minutes of play left. And the 1979 BRL Winfield Trophy in the balance, and the crowd in the outer. Very pro-South. Chanting the South-South song now. Strudwick to feed. Richards can't get down. Richards still can't get down. Now they're in. South ball. Solder. Well, as you said, David, they must score points now.
Well, they've got Valley
and,
on the rack, really.
Lay the ball.
Yes, and Valleys have ended up with it. And really, South have had Valleys on the rack. You can see the difference in the two sides. The spirit is there in South at the moment. And there's a little bit of panic and a lot of shouting going on there at Valleys, and not a great deal of work. They're going to need a big performance from fellas like Lewis to get Valleys out of this temporary slump they're in at the moment.
Ian Sommer. Sommer about 8 metres outside his own quarter. Strudwick. Peter McQuarter. A few metres outside the quarter way. Last tackle coming up. Lewis puts the kick in. And tackled. Play on indicated. South with the ball.
Well, Wally Lewis was very unlucky not to get a penalty then. The South player certainly obstructed him, and then he put him right out of the play afterwards.
Meninga. David Brown. 10 metres inside Fortitude Valley territory. Gould. Salter. Kellaway. Bob Kellaway. Can't put the big man on the ground. Solder. Mal Connell. Connell looking to get the ball away. Unable to. Gould, David Brown on the last tackle. Billy Argyros back to Gould. Can they score in the last tackle? Now it goes to Keeley. That's bent over. Keeley steps. Looks for support on the inside. Finds Kellaway. Kellaway goes across. Back the other way. It runs into Tommy Duggan. Last tackle on the scrum to pack.
The defence from Valleys, and they're not really letting...
Channel O Brisbane, in association with Centre Promotions, is proud to present the good old days of vaudeville, commencing at Her Majesty's Theatre on Tuesday, the 25th of September, for a limited season only. Starring Ron Lees, acclaimed as one of the world's truly great voices, singing all your favourite songs from the good old days, and with special guest stars. From London, star of English comedy stage, Johnny Lockwood. From the Follies Bergère, the great vaudeville queen, Edith Dahl. With gorgeous girls and glamorous ballet, there are singers, a full stage orchestra, commencing on Tuesday the 25th of September, Her Majesty's Theatre, for seven shows only, nightly at 8 p.m. and matinees Wednesday and Saturday at 2 p.m. From Scotland, star of the comedians and one of the music hall greats, Jimmy Laurie. From the continent, the fabulous Bobo and Babs, traveling comedy stars extraordinaire. Counter bookings open, and there's a limited season only, so book now. Adults $7.90, students and pensioners $4.50. While in Brisbane, our artists stay at the Unum, Corrie and Sunnybank motels.
It's Bissell Clean Sweep Trade-In Time at Meijer, the easiest way you ever picked up a $5 saving. Trade in any old cleaning aid on a Bissell carpet-caring product, and Meijer give you $5 off. Rush this limited offer and save on the Bissell Gemini Carpet Sweeper, or the Cassette Simple Sweep Easy or 8000R, even the Bissell Foam Master or 9000S Carpet Shampooers. The Bissell Clean Sweep Trade-In at Meijer. Hurry, it's the easiest way you ever picked up a $5 saving.
Burt Reynolds is Gator McCluskey. He's a booze-running, motor-gunning, law-breaking rebel. He hits the screen like a bolt of white lightning. Whether he's racing the law or chasing the ladies, Gator's the fastest thing alive. White lightning. For the first time on television, Sunday, 8:30, Channel O.
The defence from Valleys, and they're not really letting South play their open game. They're moving up well, and what's been typical of Valley's defence is they might have missed that first tackle, but there's always been someone there to cover up for them. It's been a real swarming defence and a real team effort in defence out there this afternoon.
Ball in by Stradwick. Referee Eddie Ward wants it again in the third grade premiership. Winner man, he defeated Valley's 5-0. That was a tough one. Penalty going to Southern Suburbs. In third grade, the Tom Berry coached Winner Manly team coming up winners by 5-0. Congratulations to Tom Berry and his Winner Manly boys. But the Valley boys, coached by Bob Wilson, put in a great effort. It was 5-0 after about 8 minutes, and it finished at 5-0. In reserve grade, Brothers 26, Eastern Suburbs 8, and Eastern Suburbs led by 8-0 after about 10 minutes as well. And Brothers stormed home with two tries from Johnny Alro to win handsomely by 26-8. So Johnny Smith has done the impossible dream and won the reserve grade premiership against Tony Scott's Eastern Suburbs team. Can South get points on the board? That's the burning question. Mal Connell. Connell, 7 metres out. Valley's leading by 9-0. 18 minutes of play gone, second half. David Gould, John Sola, Chris Keeley, Bruce Astell. The defence is still too good from Valleys. Mal Meninga. Meninga decides to run himself. Put down, 13 metres out. On the last tackle, David Gould to distribute from the dummy half position. Gould to Solder. Once again the bomb. South to all onside. Lewis is there. Flies for it. Takes it. Loses it. Southern Suburbs ball or a knock on? No, a knock on. And once again, the pressure's on Fortitude Valley if they lose this scrum.
We've yet to see Johnny Salter do one of his little darting runs. He's been moving the ball out. And as he said on our Saturday morning show last week against East, he just kept moving the ball. Then he thought it was about time to have a go. And I'm sure we're going to see a little dashing run from Salter before too long.
South win the scrum. Tony Gibson. Gibson, 10 metres out. 5 left in this lot of 6. Valley still hold the half-time lead of 9-0. No points scored in this second half, and we're almost halfway through the second half. Southern Suburbs, 4 left in this lot of 6, 9 metres from scoring. David Brown, pulled out, 2 metres out. David Gould, John Sola, Bob Kellaway. But the Valley's defence is strong. Still 10 metres out. David Gould, Solder, Mal Connell, McIntyre to Bruce Astill. Astill still 10 metres out, so Southern Suburbs started 10 metres from the line. This is the last tackle. Can they score in the last one? Johnny Solder. Solder's flying through and Neil's lost it. Whoa. That was close.
He grounded the ball, George, so I think it would have been considered a dead ball. Very close, and he could quite easily have winded himself there.
I think that's Lewis down, David, not McNeil. Strudwick, I'm sorry. Ross Strudwick down, not McNeil. Here's the replay of the incident. Johnny Solder. Lewis impedes his progress. Neil grounds it, flicks it up in the air. Strudwick dives on it. And I think he must have just slightly winded himself. Played a restart. Here's the front-on shot. And you'll see Neil dive at it. Yes, he presses it, that's for sure. And Strudwick comes in to retrieve the situation. And I think he's just winded himself. Back to the action. Southern Suburbs with the ball still. Well, they've had enough ball to score tries, Des.
They certainly have, George, but they don't seem to be working for anything when they get near the try line. It's just a matter of each individual has a go, and then you know, they're not actually working for any particular part of the field or for any set moves that they could have on.
Brian Weir, a metre or so inside, belly quarter way, last tackle coming up. Chris Keeley, Keeley fires it to Connell, he's dropped it, picked up by Astill. But a knock on incurred. And another scrum to pack. Those scrums are evening up. Valleys have the scrums their way. 11-10 now. 11-10. Penalties favouring South. 6-3. This scrum on the Valley quarterway. Strudwick looking at the clock and thinking, by golly, there's still 20 minutes of play remaining. Alan Mills on his own quarterway. Wally Lewis. Peter McWhirter. Pull down. Mal Connell, the tackler. Strudwick. Lewis. Breaks through. The brilliance of Wally Lewis. Chris Close. Close. Whoop. Almost knocks Eddie Ward over. So two strong runs from Lewis and Close have taken the play from the Valley quarter line to well inside Southern Suburbs territory. Mills now. Put down. On the last tackle. Neil. Duggan. Tom Duggan. Scrum to pack. 7 metres short of the Southern Suburbs quarter way.
Well, Valleys will be very relieved to get out of their own quarter because they've been battling there for the last 15 minutes or so to get out. And Ross Strudwick, who was looking at the clock at the last scrum, has just done the same thing, but he'll be a lot happier that he's a lot closer to the clock this time than he was last time.
Ball in by John Solder. McNeil. Tackled by Solder and Argyros. Lewis. Just short of the Southern Suburbs quarterway. Neil. Sommer. Just inside the quarter. Another try here to Fortitude Valley. Could almost wrap this 79 premiership up, and they know it. Strudwick. Alan Mills. Mills. Good tackle, David Gould. Mills, a very hard man to tackle. He plays it forward. Has Strudwick in support. Can't get the ball to Strudwick. On the last tackle. Strudwick indicating he's going to put it in the air. There it goes. Left foot kick. Near the sticks. Players flying from everywhere. Falvey has it. Six to go indicated. Touch by Mal Meninga. Correct decision from Eddie Ward. Can Valley score now? Strudwick. Vic Whelan. 9 metres out. Four left, missed out of six. Lewis. McGuinness on the burst. 2 metres out. Three left in his lot of six. Paul Richard to dummy half. John McLeod. Over! 12-0. John McLeod is the try scorer. It was inevitable, David.
Yes, George, and here it is on replay. And McLeod, they use the blind side, and McLeod charges hard, and that's determination because he had to go through two South defenders and sneaks across and just gets the ball down in his left hand, and Eddie Ward coming around on the spot to award the try.
Head on, it looked just like this. There's big old McGuinness charging at the defence. Put into the turf, 2 metres out. McLeod going across to the blind side. Richards looking open side, but all the time he knew he was going to shoot at blind side. Johnny McLeod confronted by Mick Graham, Tony Gibson, and the ball will go down now. By golly, that's close. But 3 points and a great determined effort from the diehards, second try, and leading by 12 points to nil with 15 minutes of play remaining, Des Morris.
Yes, George, I think that'll be the try that they were after since half-time. And I think it was Wally Lewis and Chris Close that started that off quite a few minutes ago with runs out of their own 25.
David, can you see the Magpies getting into it now?
No, I can't, George. And I think really South had to score when they had Valleys on the rack, and Valleys' defence held true. And that's the difference between the two sides, I think, this afternoon. We've seen South in Valleys' quarter for a good 15 minutes of this half, and they're unable to get across. Valleys got down there for 2 minutes, and they're across the line immediately. McNeil moves in for the conversion.
Taking his time, he's kicked 3 out of 3. 4 out of 4. Had to wait for that one. She just dropped through and that was all. 14-0. Valleys leading with about 14 minutes of play left in the 1979 BRL Winfield Grand Final here at Lang Park, and you're watching Channel O's action.
Came back to take over the 5-8 spot, and they found one out in the wing. Unfortunately for Mark Spencer, who's also played very well this year. But we could see Valleys now open the game up a lot more. I think a lot of pressure is off Valleys now. They knew they couldn't afford to let South score, and they didn't want to make mistakes when they only had that lead of 9-0. Now with 14-0, we're going to see, by the look of it, from what Strudwick just did then, that Valleys are going to play the ball down in South's territory, make it very hard for South to get out of there. And then I'm sure we're going to see a lot more ball movement from Valleys in the backup that we've known that they've done this year. They've averaged something like 5.5 tries per match this year, and that's good attack in anybody's business.
And Solis put the boot to the ball. Falvey charging back after it. It'll stop before it gets to the line, and Peter Falvey with the ball. So Solis hasn't lost the game yet as far as he's concerned. I'm going to put the ball back down there and see if we can score tries from down there. About 30 minutes of play remaining, and Valleys have scored 2 tries to nil, lead by 14 points to nil. Chris Close, another bullocking run. Tom Duggan. Well, both Tom Duggan and David Brown in our pre-match interviews said that they held no fears for any other man on the field. And by golly, both of them have played that way, David.
Yes, it's been a very strong
six
match.
Six to go, Wally Lewis, the McQuarter. What about that Wally Lewis as a footballer? McQuarter puts it down.
I think he might have knocked it on, George. I think he's fairly lucky.
We'll soon find out on the replay if he has. But we'll take it.
Here's McQuarter. McQuarter to Lewis.
Was judged on the best player in every game. We didn't say the best and fairest player. We just said the best player. And if he's not one of the best players here today, I'm eating my hat as well. And McQuarter puts the ball down. But what a footballer, young Wally Lewis. Superlatives can't wrap him up, Des.
That's right, George. He's had a great game today. He has his little lopes in behind the line, but when he does come in to do something, he certainly doesn't muck around. As I said before, he's got all the skills. He can do anything he likes, and it's players like that that win grand finals.
McNeil kicks the goal, 19-0, and Des just mentioned that Wally Lewis does have a few little lapses behind the play, and if you do watch the play closely, he does. But by golly, I reckon he earns them.
I reckon he does.
So Valleys, is that Svensson on there?
Look like Svensson.
Yes,
Georgia.
They put Svensson on for a run. Svensson on, and I surmise that Falvey's gone off.
No, still there.
Falvey's still there? I'd have to find who's gone off. Falvey's still there, so Svensson's on. And we'll have a look around in a moment to see who he's replaced. Who do you think, Des? Vic Whelan.
I think so.
No, I think he's in the pack, George. I think he's replaced McLeod.
I'll have to work him out here in a moment. Valley's keen.
Yeah, I think you might be right, though.
Yes, I think he has replaced McLeod too.
Because Vic's definitely still out there.
Studwick shapes the kick, fires a long one. Studwick really playing the fiddle now, David. Chris close.
Well, playing the fiddle, pulling the buttons, pulling the strings, George. He's done it all year and he's done it again today. It's been a great effort by Strudwick. He took over the captain coach job after Valleys were defeated last year. And he calls all the shots for Valleys and they respond to every whim of his.
Desi must be a great competitor to play against.
Well, that's right. He is, George. He never knows when to stop, and after the game, he's, he's just the perfect sportsman, really. He doesn't like losing, but once he has lost, or which he hasn't been too often this year, if you point out before, but he is a great sportsman.
Mark Svensson having a run from dummy half. He's fresh. Can he bust through? Still 9 minutes of play remaining in the 1979 Grand Final, and Valleys after more points. Tommy Duggan playing his last game for Valleys and would love to score a try. 2 metres out. Valleys leading by 19 points to nil. Two converted tries in the space of 4 minutes. In the second half, the 25th and the 29th minute, a field goal from Wally Lewis. An extra point, thinking all the time, has all the skills, as Des Morris said. Lewis with a big grin on his face now. An extra point, Valleys lead by 20 points to nil. And Southern Suburbs will have to wait, let's hope, not another 16 years. The last time they played here was in 63. And just for a matter of interest, I'll run through the team that played that year. They were defeated by North's 17 points to 8. The fullback was Stan McDonald. The wingers were Dennis Farrell and Trevor Gaylor. The centres were Kel Cranston, their captain, Frank Drake in the centre. Garth Budge and Ivan Jones were the halves. Stan Gayton played at lock forward. Bruce Bond and Ken Aiken were the second row forwards. The big mate from the mountain, Mick Beavers, was one prop forward. Reggie Webster was the hooker. And Jim Murdoch was the other prop forward in that Southern Suburbs team that last played here in a grand final in 1963, and they were defeated by North's 17 points to 8. Long time between drinks for the Magpies, David.
Yes, George, but I was talking to Warren Kenwood, South's assistant coach, before the match in the dressing room, and he tells me that South are almost certain to retain every player in this side for next year. So we've seen what Valleys can do after holding onto a side for a year. They've come back to win the premiership and win it in fine fashion. And if South can retain the side, there's youth, enthusiasm, there's brilliance. And although they've been thoroughly outplayed by a cool professional unit this afternoon, this side has got a lot of potential. They've done it. They should be congratulated for getting this far and getting past sides such as West and East in the run into this match. And I think although they've been thoroughly outplayed, as I said today, they could look forward to next year with great hopes, because I think they've got the basis of a very good side.
And of course, at this stage, the natives are getting restless in the outer. And some of that, away goes Mark Svensson. Some of the lubrication that they've been using during the game is starting to take effect. And there's a few minor skirmishes around the place. The football goes on, the ambulance has come onto the field. I don't know what for at this stage. Someone has been injured or up in the outer. There's the constabulary. Al McGuinness goes on with it. McGuinness, the ambulance getting there in a big hurry. McGuinness about 15 metres from scoring Valley's lead by 20 points to nil. Three tries, Tommy Duggan. Duggan on the last tackle now. Richards, Studwick, a drop and goal. Another one. An extra 1 point. 21 points to nil. Two field goals. And it's a long time since we've seen field goals. And Des Morris has sweet memories of field goals. 72, Des. Tell us about it.
Well, it was a bit later than this, I think, in the game. And Jeff Weiss plucked one out of... nowhere. We won the game 16-15, but that was 8 years ago. And
that was against Fortitude Valley.
That was against Fortitude Valley, that's right.
A lot of dust here at Lang Park this afternoon. Don't think your television set's playing up or that there's something wrong with our cameras. But there's not much grass on Lang Park this late in the year. Plenty of dust. And by golly, won't both those teams enjoy a drink after this one, David?
Yeah, they sure will, George. And it seems that McNeil didn't have any trouble with the new goalpost here at Lang Park. He's kicked 5 out of 5. They must look just as good as the old ones.
Yeah. penalty going to Southern Suburbs late in the game. Solder takes the kick for touch. And Southern Suburbs on the attack. Can they score points in this final? I'm sure they'd love to put points on. Down 21 points to nil and three tries scored against them. They've been beaten. They've been beaten thoroughly by Fortitude Valley. Bob Kellerwave going close. All the accolades go to Valleys. But played back. Valley ball. So that's the chance gone. Southern Suburbs, a really great effort, David, because I think everyone really expected Valleys to win, but they thought that Southern Suburbs just might come through with something, but they haven't been able to, but they've held them down, Valleys, till the 25th minute of the second half at 9-0, which was a great effort, but they didn't capitalise on their opportunities.
That's exactly it, George. I think at 9-0, South Room with a chance, and they had plenty of attacking opportunities, and as Des said, they fell down because they lacked variation when they got near the line, and it was Valley's defence that just continually kept swarming all over them. And South, I think, could have put up a couple of little more bombs when Solder put the little low grubber kick through. That had Valley's in some sort of trouble, and maybe just a little bit more variation in their attack. Could have seen them get points on then, and we would have seen a whole new ball game. They didn't. Valley's came back and replied very early, and that really saw the end of the match.
Well, one very disappointed man will be Greg Beavers. There he is. He led the team out, still got his jumper on, number 14. And it was his great wish to lead Valleys, to lead Souths to a premiership win, as the assistant coach, Warren Kenwood, beside him on the right. But I don't think even the great Greg Beavers would have made the difference this afternoon, David.
Well, no, George, but I'm sure, as you say, he would have loved to have been out there. I think... you know, we can't say too much about this Valley side. They've been the best side all year, and I think they thoroughly deserve to win the grand final. Souths have come from behind on a couple of occasions, but they weren't good enough today against a much better side.
Valleys have a free kick. I mean, a penalty kick. And Alan Mills will kick for touch on the grandstand side. Stay with us after the final hooter goes, because... we'll have a summary of the game by Des Morris and David Wright. Also, you'll see the cup being presented. The lap of honour by the victors, Valleys. Away goes Tommy Duggan. Can he score a try before he goes back to Wandai? No, he can't. Pull down. 4 minutes left. Al McGuinness on the run now. Charging into the quarter way. And, of course, we'll be taking our cameras to the dressing rooms to talk to the elated Valleys team and the despondent Southern Suburbs team. They should have some interesting things to say. Vic Whelan brushing him off now. And Whelan is about 11 metres from scoring. Valley's leading by 21 points to nil. Three tries, five goals and two field goals. The 21 points. Mark Svensson. Svensson to Stradwick. Stradwick now to Chris Close. Close scored the first important try. Could score two to McNeil. He knocked the ball on. Not an easy one to hang on to. It was a downward movement, basketball type pass from Chris Close. But McNeil put it down. He can be well satisfied with his performance. With five goals from five attempts. The injured Southern Suburbs player. There's the replay, and he got his hands to it, but couldn't hang on to it. A knock-on resultant. Studwick, Lewis, Neil goes around him. Can he score now? No. Held up, put down. McGuinness a dummy half. Duggan getting ready to get the ball. McGuinness says, I'm going to score one. No, he can't. Neil, Lewis, long floating pass. If they pick it up, they'll score. Whelan picks it up on the bounce. The Wally Lewis pass. The rugby union background of Wally Lewis. A beautiful torpedo pass. Just watch how far it goes. There's Lewis. It goes a good 25 metres. Vic Whelan just has to accept it to score the try. Four tries, 24 points to nil.
Well, that's a set move by Valleys, and they've used it plenty of times this year. Lewis attempting to find Strudwick, and Strudwick knows he can't get to it, lets it bounce, wasn't interested in it, and Vic Whelan just comes through to get the ball on the bounce, and it's a simple matter to run in and score the try.
Some pretty fine defensive performances this afternoon, George, and none better than Bill Argyros. Chalked up 40 tackles, and he hasn't let South down. And for Peter McWhirter, well, we expected him to do his tackling share. He's chalked up 30 for a 5-8, and he's played as the extra forward for Valleys. For Valleys, well, they were the complete team again. It's hard to pick anyone who didn't do their part. Alan Mills really didn't do anything wrong, and McNeil has done very well. He's got 5 out of 5 to date, and he's about to attempt to convert this goal and try and make it 6 out of 6. I thought when Chris Close got near the ball, he was very destructive, and also Peter McWhirter, as I said, in the defensive department. McNeil converts it and makes it 6 out of 6. And the score, 26 points to nil, turning out to be a real thrashing. Well, Ross Strudwick's generalised again, and he's been the thinker behind the Valleys side. Wally Lewis, a couple of patches of brilliance from Lewis, and that's been enough for him to...
I'll just butt in here for a minute, David. The greatest travesty of justice in any grand final, and Des Morris will vouch for it. If the BRL don't spend some money and put a fence around Lang Park, the grand final will never be the same ever again, Des.
Georgia, as you can see, there's thousands of kiddies running onto the field now, and it's a pretty upsetting moment for some players out there at the moment.
Well, Des, your thoughts on the game?
It was a good game, George. I think Valley's dictator turns right from the word go. They had a slump in the second half, just after half-time. A couple of strong performances by Lewis and Close to get them out of trouble. They just lifted themselves a little bit above other players on the field and took the play to the South. From those ruts or runs from the players, they've Valleys have crossed the try by McLeod that broke the camel's back sort of thing, and after that it was all Valleys.
David?
Well, George, I thought it was really Valleys' defence in the early part of the second half that saved the game for them. When South threw everything at them, it was Valleys' defence that held. And then after it had held, they just hit the accelerator and their attack was much too good. They had plenty of possession. Scrums went their way 17-10. The penalties went against them 7-4. But I particularly like the attitude in which the game was played. There wasn't any viciousness about it. There was no spite amongst any of the players. It was played hard and a great game of rugby league. Valleys the deserving winners and the best side throughout 1979.
Full-time score once again. Valley 26, South 0. The try scorers, Chris Close, Vic Whelan, Peter McWhirter, and John McLeod for Valleys. McNeil kicked 6 out of 6, a field goal to Ross Studwick, and a field goal to Wally Lewis. There's the jubilation on the ground at this present moment. We'll take a commercial break and come back with the Metro Ford man of the match in the dressing room.
Here it is, the big one from Cape Town. Action replay.
When my baby's walking down the street, I see red.
Gilder, Kelly Marie, Blondie. Get the action right here with Doug Parkinson, Skyhooks, Dragon. The Baby. Action. Action replay at $6.99 from K-Town.
Available at Meijer, David Jones, Homecrafts, Walton's, Parling, King & King, Day & Grimes, Pickett's, Chandler's, Woolworth's larger stores.
Sailing through the summer breeze, me and my Venus girl. Smiling through her Venus, smiling through her Venus eyes. She smiles, 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 smiling, smiling through her Venus eyes.
Venus sunglasses are available at your Green Spot chemist.
I couldn't go past Ross Strudwick for the $100 Metro Ford man of the match. Ross was in everything and must be a very happy man right at this moment.
Thank you, David. What a tremendous win. Mate, it was only 12 months ago, almost to the second, that most of us guys were sitting here with tears in our eyes and wondering, well, will we stick together or won't we stick together? I sound like a politician. Here we are, 12 months later, and we've got it under our belts. What a tremendous win, mate. That's bloody tremendous. Fellas, let's hear the song, eh?
Good! We know
I've got the boys here. Wally Lewis, how does it feel, Wally?
Oh, it feels really good, George. And as Ross said, 12 months ago, we had tears in our eyes, and we got tears in our eyes again. You know?
How about you, Squirter?
It's good to be a diehard, George.
Peter Falvey, he wasn't there last year.
Oh, great, George.
How about Johnny McLeod, who went over for a try?
It's just the greatest feeling of my life. It's like...
And Elkie Simon got there at last.
Yeah, steel, mate, steel.
Tommy Duggan, when are you going back to Wandai?
Bye-bye, Lang Park.
That's the scene from the Valley's dressing room. Much jubilation. We'll go around and see what's happening at Southern Suburbs.
In the Southern Suburbs dressing room, things were a little bit quieter, and Southern Suburbs assistant coach Warren Kenwood must be a little disappointed.
Yes, George, very disappointed. Valley's played great football. Brakes just didn't go our way.
Did you think you'd get into it at any stage?
Yeah, just after half-time, I thought we were still into it. You know, if we had scored a quick try, we might have just pulled it out of the bag, but Valley's hit back and they just didn't let up.
Live to fight another day.
Oh, my word, next year, George, they'll be there.
Okay, well, a couple of the boys are out there in the thick of the battle. David Gould, how'd you pull up, David?
A bit sore, George. They played pretty well, but, you know, that's the way the game goes.
Obviously disappointed.
Yeah, very disappointed.
And Noel Meninga, who came in for his fair share of punishment during the game. How do you feel, pal?
I'm okay, George.
Are you?
Yeah, no worries.
What's wrong with the shoulder? Are you serious?
No, not too serious, I hope.
Give it away now for a while.
There next year, George.
Thanks, mate. McGregor just wasn't Southern Suburbs day.
No, George, no. Beaten by a better side, much better side on the day, yeah. They played very well, Valleys, didn't they?
They did. Did you think that you could get back in at any stage?
Yeah, at half time, I thought we were still in. I thought 9 points, you know, if we would have hung in there, which we anticipated prior to half time,
yeah,
we could hang in there at 9 points, we were looking good, you know.
What was the feeling in the room at half time?
Real good, mate. I thought all the guys were very geared up, you know, they were all hot to trot, and we followed. Probably that weak lapse that Valley's had may have come our way, you know, but they're too good in our day, simple as that.
Okay, well, that's it from the Valley's, from South's dressing rooms, of course. That's the end of our football for 1979. On behalf of David Wright and myself, I hope you enjoyed the replay, and I'll catch you again next Saturday morning. Till then, good evening, and thanks for being with us.
Israel.